So where we are is in Britain's deep underground science facility called Boulby Underground Laboratory. We're 1.1 kilometers below ground. We are one of the world's few deep underground science sites. So my name's Sean Paling. I'm the director of this place, which is Boulby Underground Laboratory. Where we are is 1.1 kilometers below ground in North Yorkshire. And in this laboratory, we've got all sorts of low background radiation science projects. They're mostly particle physics projects in this lab anyway, and they need to be in a very, very quiet place. And deep underground here, we're shielded from a lot of the natural radiation you get on the surface. The stuff called cosmic rays. When you're on the surface, you're being bombarded with natural radiation from space called cosmic rays. Here, it's a million times quieter. So experiments that need to be away from that interference come here, and they have a quiet place to do their science. So what's through here is our pride and joy, actually. This is called the Bugs Lab. It stands for Boulby Underground Screening Facility or Laboratory. In there are very, very sensitive particle detectors that are very good at screening materials to see what radioactive elements are in there. Everything is slightly radioactive. A piece of metal, the air is slightly radioactive, plastic's radioactive, we're even slightly radioactive. And so if you take a piece of material and you put it in one of these very sensitive particle detectors, it gives you a spectrum of the radioactivity coming off that material. And that's useful for all sorts of things. It's really useful for building new dark matter detectors, because you want to use very, very pure materials that don't give off much radiation. So it's really, really useful for that. And we use this to build some of the best dark matter detectors in the world. But it's also useful for other types of studies trying to understand what materials are made of. You can do types of radio dating in here. You can do environmental gamma spectroscopy and all sorts. So this bit of kit is a dark matter detector, one of our dark matter detectors here. So it's called Drift. This is a machine that is trying to solve one of the biggest questions in physics, and that is, what is the universe made of? Most physicists and astronomers now think that when you look at the night sky, the stuff that you can see, the planets and the stars, and everything you can see with a telescope makes just a small percentage of what's actually out there. We think most of what's out there is dark and you can't see it. There's lots of reasons why we think that. One of the most obvious ones is if you look at how things move in space, there's far more pulling of gravity going on that can be explained just by what you can see. But overall, we think the missing mass in the universe is something like 85%. It's been called dark matter, but we haven't proven what it is yet. The best bet of what it is some sort of subatomic particles that are everywhere in space, but all around us now. This is what we think. And the idea is, or what we're trying to do with this, is prove if that's true or not. So it's a very, very sensitive particle detector. It's a machine that goes ping when a particle hits it. If we were running this on the surface of the Earth now, it would be going ping, 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 ping all the time with background radiation. Here in this lab, it's a million times quieter because we've got this wonderful shield above our heads of 1.1 kilometers of rock. So it's a million times quieter. So this is in a better place to look for pings due to dark matter. There are a number of detectors around the world, something like 10 or so, all looking for dark matter. This one is different to most of them. It's not the most sensitive in the world, this, but it's one of the cleverest. And what it does, as well as going ping when a particle hits it, it can tell the direction of the particle that hits it. If you can build a dark matter detector like that, and if you detect dark matter, and you can tell what direction it's coming from, it really gives you a signature that what you're seeing really is dark matter, not some other type of background radiation. So this, in a sense, is a dark matter telescope, and it is amongst the most sensitive dark matter telescopes in the world. So this is the Drift dark matter detector, and over here we have another one of our detectors underground, and it's called NEWS-G. It's a small one, but it's a very important one. It's trying to detect dark matter in a different way than many of the other dark matter detectors in the world. Whenever you build a dark matter detector and you run it, you're actually looking for a range of dark matter particles. If you find a dark matter particle, great, you get a Nobel Prize. If you don't, you get to rule out a class of particles. Oh, it's not those, it's not those. So different particle detectors are trying to rule out different classes of particles. This one is trying to be very clever and rule out very low mass dark matter particles. Some people think dark matter particles are very, very heavy. Some people think they're going to be very, very light. It's quite hard to detect light particles, and this one is trying to be clever and trying to do that. It's a small sphere with a gas in it and a very, very sensitive bit at the center, which means when particles come in, it can detect very, very tiny signals. It can detect lower mass dark matter particles. This is an R&D experiment. This is only a small one. It's testing the technology. So the idea is what we do is we build these systems, we test them, we develop them until they work beautifully. And when they do, for instance, this one, we then want to build a bigger version and run it in this laboratory. It will then be, when it's a bigger one, one of the most sensitive dark matter detectors in the world, tailored to look for light dark matter particles. When we expand this detector, it's about what? Oh, it's about 40 centimeters now. This will be 3 meters in diameter. It'll be made of pure copper, and it'll be running at the end of the lab up there.